So one thing we must realize, and we kind of talk about this in a program that we do, that is known as the art of leading collectively. See, the previously leadership was taken as a capacity of an individual to lead a group of people towards a common goal. However, today, no single leader can make that happen. Every single one of us, irrespective of where we are a leader in our own self. So we collectively need to energize each other and lead each other. And before we lead each other, we need to start leading ourselves first. With that in context, there are four areas that need to be worked on. Collaboration happen within organizations and specifically within teams. Now, every team must have something known as a team purpose statement. What is a team purpose statement? Like an organization mission, which every organization has, but nobody connects with it because every team has got a specific role and that organization mission truly does not connect with them. Every team must be able to create its own team purpose statement, or in short, their own team mission. Now, this team mission would be a vision which is larger than an individual, but which combines the team in a manner that they start working for a bigger goal. Please remember, every time you feel that you are a part of a journey of achieving a larger goal than yourself, you will find yourself more excited. In fact, if I take an example of my army life, now in the army life, we do not ever command, or we never do show leadership by commanding, because nobody can be commanded if he has a... So how do we command? We create that vision of this group of people trying to save the integrity of the nation. And because the vision is so big, so large, so exciting, so inspiring, that each person in that team is ready to even give his own life. Now, having a team purpose statement, bigger inspiring vision, is not good enough if we do not follow this up with team goals. Again, we have organizational goals, we have KRA, KPIs. Now, if you are measuring everybody through a KRA and a KPI, which is individual, how can you expect them to be collaborative? So the way to make collaboration happen is make team goals and connect everybody's appraisal based on the team goals that have been achieved. So the moment I, you and others of the team all get connected towards a team goal which we have to achieve jointly, where I have a role to play, you have a role to play, the third person has a role to play, you will suddenly find us being more collaborative, because unless we are collaborative, that team goal cannot be achieved. Again, having a vision, having the goals are not good enough if we don't go to the third level, that is engagement. And the engagement would be on a weekly basis, every single team member committing to each other to say, this week, this is what I'm going to do. This week, this is how I'm going to contribute in another team member's growth or help him achieve his target. So when team members make those commitments to each other on a weekly basis and follow through on it, you will find more collaboration taking place. And last but not the least, every team, at least on a monthly basis, must go through something known as, and we call it a team learning session, where the collective intelligence of the team is tapped into so that we can identify some best practices some team member is doing and then use that best practices by other team members so that the overall outcome of the team becomes better.